Earlier in the wee hours, the PLA stormed the square. The students put up the statue, you know, the goddess of democracy. The Chinese would not allow such an obvious Western symbol to be facing down and staring down Mao. They say, HS, you are in charge. We would like to have a picture to show us what the square looked like now in the morning. So I asked one of our AP photographers, Jeff Widener, to say, I said, you go now. And I remember early days, I have a girlfriend who lived in Beijing Hotel. And I remember the room and the balcony. You have a, you can, you know, with a long lens, you can look at the square. That was the only place high enough. I say, hitch a ride with the Chinese on a bicycle. And he called me about 2 hours later. He said, Liu, I have this guy, you know, standing in front of the tanks. I said, take the roll of film out of your camera now and separate the film from your camera. And I said, leave both the camera and the film in the room and come downstairs to the Beijing Hotel lobby first. Look for somebody, pay him to be our messenger, ask him to bring me back the film. You stay behind. A blonde American guy with a ponytail, with a backpack, with an AP envelope said, where is there Mr. Liu here? Almost as soon as the pictures of men in front of the tanks was the first AP picture went out. There were five photographers who took it. It was coincidentally happened that a lot of photographers who came down get stabbed by the electronic prod, getting their films confiscated by the plainclothes, the Chinese security police in the Beijing Hotel. So that day we put out one horizontal and one vertical. The head of the AP, in an old-fashioned way, he sent us a cable. He said, thanks, because today the AP owned the world, meaning we own all the front page.